In order to figure out the force P required to hold the 100-pound weight in the equilibrium position for the pulley system as shown in the figure, we can start by developing the free body diagram of pulley A to calculate the tension in the rope connecting pulley A, which is linked to pulley B and pulley C. Eventually, we can calculate the load P required to keep this thing in equilibrium. So to start, for our free body diagram of pulley A, the weight of 100 pound is acting vertically downward, and I have two ropes going in the upward direction. Now for the rope, the force will always be in tension. That's why they are going away from the pulley, given as TA. Next, we can apply the equilibrium condition to solve for this tension that is coming as 50 pound. Now, next, move to our pulley B and develop the free body diagram. Now in this case, the rope that is connecting pulley A and pulley B, the tension in that we have calculated as 50 pound, whereas I have two ropes going in the upward direction at pulley B. This tension can be again calculated by applying the equilibrium equation along the vertical axis. That gives us the value of tension as 25 pound. Finally, let's go ahead and draw the free body diagram of pulley C. The rope that is connecting pulley C and pulley B is in tension of 25 pounds, whereas the rope that is extending from pulley C towards pulley D is the same rope. So the value of tension will be constant throughout this rope. That's why I have two forces P going in the upward direction, going away from the pulley C. Applying the equilibrium condition and simplify, we get our value of P as 12.5 pounds.